In this illustration, we'll analyze the molar heat capacity of a gas in Tuna process. Here we are given that 1 mole of an ideal gas having adiabatic exponent gamma undergoes the Tuna process in which gas temperature varies with volume according to the function T is T naught e to power alpha V. And here we are required to find the molar heat capacity of the gas in this Tuna process. So, to find molar heat capacity of the gas, we can simply write according to first law of thermodynamics, we use dQ is equals to dU plus dW. And dQ we can substitute as NC dT if C is the molar specific heat of the gas in this specific process. And on the other side, dU we can write as NCV dT. As work done in differential form, we can always write as PdV. So here, the molar specific heat C can be given as CV plus PdV upon N dT. Here, in the second term, we need to substitute the variables so that we can relate the result. So here we can write from the given function, we use T is equals to T naught e to power alpha V. Then we can differentiate, this gives dT is equals to T naught alpha e to power alpha V dV. And we can write by gas law, pressure of gas we can write as nRT by V. So, in this situation, we can substitute the value of T. So, it is nRT naught by V e to power alpha V. Now, we can substitute the value of P and dT over here. So, you can see this value of C we are getting. CV we can write as R by gamma minus 1 plus pressure we are writing as nRT naught by V e to power alpha V dV divided by N dT we can write as T naught alpha e to power alpha V dV. Here you can see the value of N gets cancelled out and rest of the parameters also T naught e to power alpha V dV, these also gets cancelled out. So, value of C we are getting finally is R by gamma minus 1 plus this R by alpha V. This is the final result of this problem.